Hello, my little woolly. In today's tutorial, you will learn how to knit a pretty stitch pattern called Garter Slip Stitch. It's a 4-row repeat pattern, full of texture, super easy to do. You don't even have to purl. It's magnificent. And this is the other side of the work. I don't think it's as pretty as the right side, but it's not bad, so it could be a reversible stitch pattern. And the other most important thing is that it doesn't curl. It's kind of stretchy and firm at the same time. So it's a great stitch for a scarf, for example, or for baby stuff. So grab your needles, a little bit of yarn, and let's get started. Firstly, we need to cast on an odd number of stitches, and the repeat is really short, so I'm going to cast on just a few stitches, 9, for example. First row, right side of the work. We have to knit every stitch, or knit across. When I get to the last stitch, only on this first row, I like to work it through the back loop. So I'm going to knit the last one through the back loop. This way, we can avoid a huge loop there. Second row, as per row one, just knit every stitch. It's super easy to do and so beautiful. Knitting is just amazing. Okay, row 3. We start with knit 1, and here comes the repeat. The repeat is what you will find between asterisks on the written instructions. Remember, you can find my patterns on my website, sowoolly.net, and there is a link for you below this video, below the title of the video, in the description box. Okay, the repeat is slip 1 purlwise, just pass it onto the right hand needle as if to purl, and knit 1. That's it. Let's do it again. Slip 1 as if to purl, knit 1, slip 1, knit 1, slip 1, knit 1. So just repeat to the end of the row. Row 4, this is the last one. We start with knit 1, and here comes the repeat. Pay attention, please. With yarn in front, slip 1 as if to purl. With yarn in back, knit 1. That's it. With yarn in front, slip 1 purlwise. With yarn in back, knit 1. And repeat to the end of the row. Yarn in front, slip, yarn in back, knit. Yarn in front, slip, yarn in back, knit. These 4 rows create the pattern. And at the end of the video, I'll tell you how to bind off. Now, if you need continental style, first row, super easy, just knit every stitch. Row 2, same, just knit across the row, from the first to the last stitch. Row 3, we start with knit 1, and here comes the repeat. Slip 1 as if to purl, knit 1, slip, knit, slip, knit, slip, knit, and if you have more stitches, keep repeating to the end of the row. Row 4, here comes what I find interesting in continental. We start with knit 1, And here comes the repeat. With yarn in front, slip, yarn in back, knit. 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 Repeat these four rows until the desired length is reached. When finished, bind off knitwise after row one. That means facing the wrong side of the work. Just bind off knitwise. So, this is everything for today, my little woolly. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and happy knitting.